to y'all, Shay Love and Hip Hop Hollywood Review. Let me start off this video just by saying there is a special place in hell for people like Fizz and April. Yeah. So, we start off exactly where we left off on last week's episode with Tierra popping up out of nowhere. She tells Zell and Paris that she's going to stay with them until her apartment is ready. I was like, how you just gonna tell a motherfucker you staying with them? Bitch asks. So they asked her about her drunk driving incident that happened in New York. It was in the news over the summertime, or I think early spring or some shit, where she was drunk driving and driving on like the wheel of the tire, some shit with the tire. She was driving on the metal part of some shit. The bitch was fucked up. So Paris tells her that she's disappointed in her and asks her how many times she's got to hit rock bottom basically for her to get it together. And I understand and I fully appreciate the fact that they're showing her tough love now. They're just not letting her slide by saying, oh, Tierra, well, we gonna pray for you, or we hope you get it together and we here for you. No, bitch, like how much more do you have to go through in order for you to get it the fuck together? Because you've been taking back-to-back L's. Ever since she got on this show, Tierra Marie has been taking one L after another. She used to be so polished and put together and so pretty. I remember when she was on Love and Hip Hop New York, she was just, you know, hanging with Chrissy and them. Like, she was just so cute. And then when she got on this show, like, her life just went to shit. Like, I really hope she get it the fuck together. But she gets mad and start crying when they hold her accountable because she just wants to be like, all right, y'all, I get it. I'm going to change and keep on saying the same thing. And they're holding her feet to the fire now, basically letting her know, you're like, you can sit up here and say, I'm going to get it together. But now we're looking at you like, bitch, you're lying. Like, you're not taking it as seriously as we are. So they tell her that, you know, she got to love herself as more than what they love her. And she agrees, but I still feel like she hasn't hit all the way rock bottom yet. Tierra got to go through some more shit in order for her to really, really get it together. But however, she looks great. This is the best she has looked in a long time. Her body looks great. Her face looked great. She looked really good. So Yo-Yo and her daughter talk about their discord, and I'm not going to go into the full thing, but what I really got from the whole Yo-Yo and her daughter situation is her daughter need to fucking move out. She too motherfucking grown. Two grown ass women can't live in the fucking house together. Two grown motherfuckers period can't live in the house together. And her daughter is a very intelligent one, a young woman. She's very well spoken. She seems like she's a sweet girl, but no way in hell you about to ask your mama why she come home with an attitude from work. Who you talking to? Are you paying a bill in this motherfucker? Last time I checked, my name was on the motherfucking deed, bitch. Like, excuse. No, don't ask me why. Like, basically, she was acting. The conversation was, you know, she be feeling some type of way about Yo-Yo coming home with an attitude when she come home from, you know, work or whatever the case may be. And she wants Yo-Yo to explain herself. That's your mama. This her shit. She ain't got to explain shit to you, sis. Her daughter needs to get the fuck out and get her own place for her baby daddy and her daughter and her baby that she got coming. And then you'll understand what your mama feel like when you got your own kids and she grow up and be asking you a bunch of questions. But until then, she need to fucking go. No, she need to go. She need to get her own shit. And then you ain't got to worry about your mama coming home with no attitude. Huh. So, Fizz shows April his new home that he wants her to move into. Now, I remember when Monice went on Hollywood Unlocked, she says that Fizz and April don't stay that far away from her or whatever, that they do live together, they do got them a house, so they did end up moving in with one another. April started crying again about how he was there for her when she was down on her luck and was so depressed, and how he's a good man to her and her kids. And, you know, I hope this really works out for them, because this is some trifling shit. I really hope that this works out for them. I hope they are each other's soulmates, because, baby, the way that they are doing the other people in their lives is low down, trifling, and motherfucking dirty as shit. I feel like April more so went into this trying to make Omarion jealous, trying to get a rise out of him, and it's not working. I feel like Fizz is always probably jealous of Omarion because he was the star of the group and had the most success. And I feel like they both had their grievances, and that motivated them to do this foul ass shit that they're doing. I think that they really do care about each other now, but the motives behind it is so fucked up. So you know the saying, how you go into a relationship and how it will end. This is not going to end well for either one of them. I just hope they're making the right decisions, baby, because please believe you reap what the fuck you sow. Karma is a motherfucking. People don't be realizing, like, the energy you put out into this world, that shit comes back on you tenfold. I've seen it. I've dealt with it. And the shit might not happen today and it might not happen tomorrow, but it is factual and it will come back on you. Y'all, they gonna reap this shit, baby. They gonna reap it, baby. You know, Ray J is supposed to go on this Immature tour. I just saw a report the other day that said that he backed out of the tour so he can spend the rest of Prinky's pregnancy with her. She reveals to Paris that she's pregnant. Zell goes to Jason and tells him about April and Fizz and shows him the pics of them in the bed together in Vegas and the video of them after the concert, all up on each other in the kitchen. And Jason pays him for the information. Do I think that that was fucked up, what Zell did? Yes, it was fucked up, but let's be honest. Zell, Paris, and April were surface level friends. They were co-workers at the end of the day. They weren't best friends. They weren't besties. They probably just got cool this season. So they really they really don't owe each other anything. So him doing what he did was fucked up. But it wasn't like, ooh, fucked up. You know, because they weren't never friends like that. That's why her reaction, like she said, April said in her confession that she already knew Zell was going to do the shit. So she just like, you know, we not going to be friends no more. Keep it moving. Like, there was never no love lost there between them two because they was never friends like that. So Yo-Yo introduces Apple to a friend of hers by the name of Mike that connects artists to brands. We find out that Apple missed the first meeting because she said she forgot. Now, come the fuck on, Apple. Come the fuck on, Apple. How the fuck you gonna sit up here and say you missed the fucking meeting? A meeting that could potentially change your whole and fucking life. Like, huh? That don't even make sense, sis. Apple don't want it for real. Apple just wants shit to land in her fucking lap. She don't really want to do the work. She got so much more work that she needs to do herself before she can really get anywhere in life. And it's kind of sad to see because she wants it, but she don't really want it as much as she says that she does. Because ain't no way in hell I'm missing a fucking brand meeting that could potentially make all of my dreams come true and gonna say I forgot. Girl, no. Like Yo-Yo said, she got wasted the night before and missed it. So the Mike guy checked out her social media and he saw that she did a live video where she was on there cussing and saying she don't give a fuck about this and then and how she sucked dick. And people need to be realizing companies now check out your social media. You think that it's a private thing, that it's something that doesn't have anything to do with your career, but companies do that a lot here now. They want to see how you behave, what type of morals you have. You know, a lot of these companies, these big brand names, are religious, have religious backgrounds to them. They have a lot of religious policies. So you have to be careful with what you post, and that's just a fact. And so he asked her to clean up her, her social media presence, and she said she don't see really anything wrong with it, and she compares what she does to Cardi B. Well, it worked for Cardi B, but that don't mean it's gonna work for you. Who are you trying to be? Are you trying to be Cardi B, or are you trying to be fucking Apple? Pick and choose, because at the end of the day, if this man sit up here and telling me, if you can clean this up, I can work with you, you think I'm not gonna do what he asked me to do? Come on now, girl. So he said he pitched her to a few companies and they weren't interested. And he tells her, you know, right now he can't see her working with her. Her attitude was poor. She didn't really seem hungry for it. She didn't come prepared. So no, she doesn't deserve it. So Princess and Ray J take new pictures for their pregnancy announcement. And I noticed he tried to hide that stomach when they took the pictures. Did y'all know he had his hand like wrapped around so you couldn't see his stomach? I was like, this nigga didn't want the world to see he was 6 months pregnant too. That shit was hilarious. So, Booby, Mr. Ray, Jason, Paris, Zell, and Sierra Marie are at Mickey Mundy's single release party at the skating rink that he said he had to scrounge up money for Child, you ain't scrounge up no money for nothing. This was a Mona Scott special. She invited some extras to come to watch you perform. Girl, that place was so goddamn empty. Child, you don't get out of here. So we learned that Jason that same day leaked the photos of Fizz and April to the blog. And as they're talking, Booby skates over and asks Jason about the pictures. Booby showed Mickey money. He was like, see, I told you this is what was going on. Booby says that he's low-key mad at them for lying to him or whatever. I think everybody should kind of be looking at them sideways. Like, what was y'all lying for? Once again, like I said on last week's video, April talk about being so motherfucking grown, but you sitting up here lying on your pussy. Girl, grow the fuck up. So Paris admits at first she was back in April, but she can't really do it no more. Then Monique walks up and asks, what's the tea? What's going on? And she hadn't seen the blog post, so they show her, and Monique's basically just walks away and goes to the bathroom because she's mad, because she's like, why the fuck was they sitting up her line in my face when I confronted them about the shit? Like, what was the point? I mean, I understand it. We all grown. If anything, what they should have did is said to Monique, look, yes, we do like each other. Yes, we're trying to figure this thing out. In the meanwhile, we don't want this to be a public situation. Can you just keep this between the three of us until we figure out exactly what we're going to do? When we do, we will let you know, because your son is involved in the situation. We want everybody to be comfortable. That's all they had to fucking do. All that sitting up there lying, saying they wasn't fucking around, April trying to confront her, and then saying, no, we don't fuck around. We're just friends. That's my best friend. That's my best friend. That's my best friend. Like, all that wasn't even fucking necessary. If y'all just would have fucking told the truth. Like the girl told you, she don't even give a fuck about that. This is about her fucking son. Because when she was on Hollywood Unlocked, Monique talked about how Fizz had, you know, got Cam for the weekend. She called Cam. Cam come to find out in Chicago at April's mom and them house. He didn't even tell her he had took this boy out of fucking town. How you taking my kid across the motherfucking country to go to some girl house? Like, what's going on? Are y'all fucking around? So, yes, I understand 100% how Monique feels. What are you lying to me about? Why are you lying to me? Why are you not communicating with me when it comes to situations with my son? How does this bitch know more about my kid when he's around you than I fucking do? Yes, that's a motherfucking problem, sir. And anybody that don't understand where this girl is coming from, I don't even know how to look at you. And for April to not understand where Monique is coming from just shows she don't give a fuck. She a low-down, dirty-ass bitch, because let Omarion do the same shit that you doing. Let Omarion have y'all damn kids around a bitch, and he lying to you saying, nah, we don't fuck around, nah, we don't fuck around. He take your kid out of town to go be with this bitch and her family, not even telling you that he taking her y'all kids somewhere for the holidays and shit. You gonna feel all kind of ways. Like, get the fuck out of here. And so for April as a mama not to understand it or not to even fucking give a damn says a lot about her as a person. She wants to pretend like she's this great person when her true colors are shining through, goddammit. Like some Cyndi Lauper type shit. So it makes me even realize more and more and more why Omarion left her. He saw the shit that we are seeing in her now. All that shit that his mama saw that we didn't see, he started to fucking see. It was a reason why he left her ass. She ain't all the way to fuck together. So, Monique, Tierra Marie follows her into the bathroom, and Monique explains to her side of the situation, and she says she doesn't like that Lil Fizz switches up when he gets a chick and he stops communicating. I would 100% agree with that. Every time you get a girlfriend, you don't want to communicate. You don't want to talk to me. You don't want to tell me what's going on with my son. But when you don't have a chick, we can be co-parenting well. Everything is fine. Like, Lil Fizz is just a little baby bitch. He's a little baby boy. He's a little fuck nigga. The nigga ain't got no money like that. He ran off and got this expensive ass crib that don't look like he gonna be able to keep the upkeep on for the, you know, the landscape and the rent, the utilities. That's a lot of house for a nigga that get a loving hip hop check. So he better make sure he make that damn tour money stretch like a motherfucker. And April sitting up here acting like she got a motherfucking prize when Monique already spilled the motherfucking tea that this nigga was staying with his motherfucking mama before he even started staying with her. Like, girl, this nigga go from pillar to post, from pot to pedal to post. Girl, get out of here. You ain't got no prize, and he ain't got no prize neither. girl, you, how would I feel having a bitch get on with social media, popping her pussy, talking about some all the niggas want to fuck her pussy, Plies want to fuck her pussy, this the other gang want to fuck her pussy, this nigga want to fuck her pussy, you want my pussy, y'all remember that video she put out about 2 months ago, this is the type of bitch you want, okay, so, April and Fizz arrive. April says that she knew Zell was going to leak the photos, like I said. Fizz says that he didn't owe anybody anything. No, you did. You owed your baby mama something. That's the only person that you owe the explanation to is your damn son's mother. Zell say he can't really be friends with April no more, and I don't blame him. Monisa and Tierra then walk up, and Paris say, you know, they said they've been together but didn't want to tell anyone. Paris say, Monisa, did you know? And she was like, no, I didn't know. And April say, I didn't have to tell her. Bitch, what the fuck? You like, see, that's where I would have leaped across. I would have leaped across that motherfucking skating rink and drop kicked that bitch that damn white onesie. Because, bitch, who you talking to? Don't try to get spicy with me because motherfuckers is around and you with this little sawed-off ass nigga. Girl, don't play with me. What the fuck you mean you didn't have to? No, technically you didn't. But when I asked you, bitch, you could have fucking told the fucking truth. Girl, I want to fight both of them. I want to fight both of them so motherfucking hard. So Monique say, just leave my son out of the bullshit. You made my son feel like he had to lie to me, and that's Drew's problem, not hers. And I'm happy that she's not putting all the blame on April, because at the end of the day, the problem does lie with little Fizzle Pop. Because why do you have put your son in a situation where you got him hiding shit from her, his fucking mama? How old are you, nigga? Are you scared of her? What the fuck you think she gonna do to you? Why is you sitting up they're making your son sit up here lie to his fucking mama, keeping secrets and shit? Like, you foul as fuck for that shit. At this point, Monise needs to take that nigga back, and they need to renegotiate this custody agreement, because no way in hell should he be allowed to do the fuck shit that he do. Yes, she fucked up in the beginning when Cam was born. She wasn't all the way together, but Monise has been pretty much mainstreaming it the last 5 or 6 years. She should be able to go back to the drawing table and renegotiate this custody agreement, because the shit that Fizz does is not fair. Ain't no way in hell you think you about to take my son across country and not think that it's okay to tell me. I called my son and find out he in a whole nother different state, bitch. I'm meeting y'all at the motherfucking gate, and I'm drop kicking each and every last one of you motherfuckers in the throat. You got me fucked up on so many different fucking levels. Your disrespectful ass. So, Monisa and them, Fizz and April walk off to go get skates. Everybody follows them over there. And I think it was Zella Perez, like, y'all not gonna, like, try to explain y'allself to her. And they walk off again because they know they wrong. And they ain't got no explanation for the shit they did. Monisa starts going the fuck off, basically saying, you know, I'm tired of being lied to. I'm tired of being made to look like the crazy person. I'm tired of being disrespected by this nigga and his bitches. And I understand exactly where she feels, because every girlfriend he's ever had on this show, he is allowed to disrespect her. And she's never allowed anybody that she's ever dated to disrespect him. She's always been, you know, very steady and, you know, and held on to the course of, I just want to co-parent with this nigga. And he seems like the one that makes the situation hard and tough. So like I said, it's a cold place in hell for a little Fizzle Pop and little Tatiana ass. Girl, good luck with that shit. Like I said, good the fuck luck with that shit. And he better hope, because if Omarion called that bitch today and said, I want to be back with you, she'd drop little Fizz like a motherfucking bad habit and go running her ass back over there. But you know what? That's all up on her. God got April ass with that little daughter of hers, Maya Mimosa, whatever that little girl name is. That's how God got her ass back, because that little boy, Mega, gorgeous. That little girl, though. God pay your ass back in ways that you never fucking expect, because y'all know that little girl ugly as shit. And that's all I got to say about that. Make sure to thumbs up this video, like and subscribe, and hit that notification bell button. If you got a problem with my joke, suck my dick. You're gonna get blocked at the end of the damn day. It's a motherfucking joke, but oh, it's the truth. Bye, y'all. Love you.